Here's what you need to know about lumbar laminectomy. The purpose of the surgery is to relieve the compression of the spinal nerves by removing the back portion of a vertebrae in your lower back. That area of bony compression on the nerves is called the area of spinal stenosis. The surgeon makes an incision to the middle of the lower spine over the area that requires bony removal. The back muscles are gently retracted to allow visualization of the bony covering or lamina and the ligaments that cover the spinal canal. Care is taken to identify and protect the nerve sac. Bone will need to be removed to better visualize the area of stenosis. Bone spurs that are found to be irritating the nerves are removed. Burrs, Cureus punches, and curettes are tools used to remove the bone, relieving the pressure on the nerve sac as well as the nerves themselves. This provides more room for the nerves to exit the foramen, which is the hole used by the nerve to exit out of the center of the spine and travel into your legs. The surgery takes 1 to 3 hours depending on the complexity of the case and the number of levels involved. In the past, patients stay in the hospital for 1 to 3 days for the initial recovery. These days, many patients can go home on the same day of the operation. The majority of patients are able to resume normal activities within a few months after operation. Why get it? Before deciding to undergo surgery, the patient should receive non-surgical treatment over the course of 6 to 12 weeks. If the pain continues to worsen or you're currently suffering from severe debilitating pain, contact your doctor to see if surgery is right for you. A lumbar laminectomy is recommended for patients whose spinal stenosis findings match their symptoms. To review, spinal stenosis is the narrowing of the space within the spine, which often results in symptoms of pain from the increased pressure or pinching of the spinal nerves. Potential complications. It is important to note that lumbar laminectomy primarily aims to reduce leg pain and improve leg function, with 85 to 90% of patients reporting improvements after surgery. Unfortunately, lower back pain does not predictably improve following the procedure. The spine bones and ligaments do have an important function of providing stability and support of the vertebrae. This stability can be compromised by removing these structures. While necessary during laminectomy, it may increase the risk for having to need a spinal fusion in the future. If you have specific questions or concerns, please discuss them with your doctor. The reoperation rate is from 10 to 15%, with the majority of patients reporting back pain as the most common complaint. Many studies have compared the outcomes of lumbar laminectomy alone and lumbar laminectomy with fusion. Laminectomies have been shown to have better outcomes when the patients report no instability. The additional fusion is reported to have better outcomes for patients with spondylolisthesis. Please review my prior video on that topic of spondylolisthesis. Ultimately, your doctor will review your symptoms and clinical findings to determine what is the best surgical approach for you. I hope this helps you understand lumbar laminectomy. Until next time, this is Dr. John Shah.